Elhamdülillah, elhamdülillah, elhamdülillah. Estağfurullah, estağfurullah, estağfurullah. El-Azim, el-Lezî, la ilahe illâhu, el-Hayyul Kayyum. Ve etûb ileyh, ve's-selâvete, ve'l-mağfirete, ve'l-hidayete, innehu et-tavvâb-er-rahîm. Ve'afu anna ya kerîm, ve'afu anna ya kerîm, ve'afu anna ya kerîm. Ve'afir lana bifadlike ya Rahman ya Rahîm. Ya Melikü, Ya Kuddüsü, Ya Hafızı, Ya Allah, El Evveli Allah, El Ahiri Allah, El Zahiri Allah, El Batini Allah, Hayrihi ve Şerrihi min Allahu Teala. Ve eşhedü enne ilahe illallah, ve eşhedü enne Muhammeden Abduhu ve Resuluhu. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Resulallah. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Habiballah. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Seyyidine l-Evveline vel-Akhirin. İşverene ya şefiyel müznidin, bir rahmetike ya arhamar rahimin. Kallallahu teala fi kitabel kerim. Euzu billahi mineşşeytanirracim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Subhanellezi esra bi abdihi leylen mina, minel mescidil harami ilel mescidil aqsa. Ellezi barakna havlehu. لِنُورِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allah-u Teala said in the book, who did take his servant from a journey by night from the sacred mosque to the farthest mosque, whose crestings we did bless in order that we might show him some of our signs, for he is the one who hears and sees. Tonight is an important night. It is the night of ascension. On this beautiful night, Resul-i Kibriya Muhammed Mustafa Sallallahu Aleyhi Vesselam was taken to a journey from Mecca to Jerusalem, then to the presence of his Lord. He conversed with him there. On this journey, he asked forgiveness for his ummah, and Allah Ta'ala granted forgiveness. On this night, he came back with a beautiful gift. With a beautiful gift from Allah Ta'ala, a gift that will enable us to do our own ascension, a gift that will bring us closer to Allah Ta'ala. On this night, he brought us a gift that will give us an opportunity to speak to our Lord. And it is the gift of Salah. We cannot come closer to our Lord when we think we are self-sufficient. We can only come closer to our Lord when we see when we are in need of Him most. Our ascension to Him starts when we start realizing that there is no one to turn to other than Him. When we realize that and submit ourselves completely to His grand will, then our ascension will start. And the most beautiful representation of this ascension is, the most beautiful representation of that state of humility is awareness of your nothingness in front of the Divine is the symbol, the representation of the Salat in the state of sajda, prostration, when we realize that we are nothing in front of His divinity. That is where we start the ascension. The event of Miraj, the event of ascension, the ascension of Rasulullah to the heavens occurred at the time when Muslims were subject to despicable treatment. These were very difficult times. Ascension started when They call that year the year of sadness. In particular, our mother, Hazrat Hatija, passed, and the uncle of Rasulullah, Abu Talib, passed at the same time. In that year, about 9 years after the first revelations, when Rasulullah sat on one corner of Kaaba, praying and asking forgiveness and asking salvation for his ummah, on the other side of the Kaaba, a curse Abu Jahl, his companions, were planning and plotting schemes against Muslims. When they saw Rasulullah, they befell on him. They started insulting at him. As this was happening, Rasulullah was in a state of prayer to his Lord for the salvation of his ummah. They started insulting him by calling him awful, by calling him illiterate, by calling him poor, lack of stature. They didn't know that when they called him orphan, Allah Ta'ala made him orphan, because when he was in difficulty, he would not seek the safety of his parents, but he would turn to him whenever he needed anything. They did not know when they called him illiterate. Allah Ta'ala was his teacher. All and everything he learned directly from Allah Ta'ala. All his divine attributes he received from Allah Ta'ala. When they called him poor, they didn't know he was proud of his poverty, that he did not need anything from anyone except Allah Ta'ala. These were the beautiful qualities. These were the beautiful qualities of Rasulullah. But Abu Jahl and his companions were saying that if God were to choose a representative, it should have been someone with stature. It would have been someone with riches, respected, a lot of people around him like themselves. Saddened by this despicable treatment that he received and his companions has received, he went to bed. He went to bed with ache in his heart and tears in his eyes. According to Ibn Abbas, our master, Rasulullah said, I had just worshipped and had gone to bed, realizing that Angel Gabriel had come. I sat up in bed. I saw Gabriel standing there and saying, O Messenger of Allah, greetings to you from Allah Ta'ala. He invites you tonight, and I have come to fetch you. Allah sent his angel Gabriel to invite Rasulullah, his beloved, to his presence on that night. And the entire journey lasted in a very short period of time, that when he came back, his bed was still warm, and the leaf which he touched on his way was still trembling. Gabriel took him from Mecca with a white animal called Burak. He first took him from Masjid al-Haram and took him to Masjid al-Aqsa. There he met with all the prophets and he led them. They prayed there. Mecca represents unity. Masjid al-Aqsa represents multiplicity. In this ascension, he combined all these multiplicity into unity. He was the one brought together all the prophets under the religion of God, Islam. Having visited seven heavens, paradise and hell, and all therein, the beloved of Allah Ta'ala was taken to the presence of his Lord. And when he was taken to the presence of his Lord, he saluted him. He saluted him and said, التهيات لله والصلوات والطيبات. All praise, blessings, good deeds, pure and beautiful, all and everything belongs to Allah Ta'ala, he said. And in response to this beautiful salutation, Allah Ta'ala saluted him back and said, السلام عليك يا أيها النبي. السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. My mercy, my compassion, my forgiveness upon you, O Prophet. Rasulullah did not stop here when he received this incredibly beautiful salutation from his own Lord. He was not satisfied. He wanted more, and he wanted more not for himself, but for his ummah. And he turned back and asked more. And he said, As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi s-salihin. He asked that all the blessings, all the salutations that he received, he also wanted the same for his people. When in front of this type of generosity, all the angels and inhabitants of the paradise repeated and said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. We bear witness that there is no God and Muhammad is his messenger, his servant and messenger. Then Allah Ta'ala complained to Rasulullah about us. He said, Oh Ahmed, how is it that while I do not ask from your people their devotions for tomorrow, but they ask from me today the sustenance that is due for them for tomorrow? Why is it that I am the one who gives all and everything to them, but they are always thankful to somebody else? Why is it that they are obedient? They obey everybody else except me. They revolt me. Why is that? I did not create the hell. I did not create the hell for them. Why should they be burning themselves in it? And he turned to Rasulullah and said, all the messengers, tell me, what did you bring me as a gift from them? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the tears in his eyes, turned to Allah Ta'ala and said, Oh Lord, I brought you two gifts. Lack of devotion, lack of obedience, world full of sins and evil. And Allah Ta'ala says, I forgive all their lack of devotion because I'm the most merciful, most compassionate one. I forgive them all, and I forgive their sins for your sake, for your intercession. And I'm sending with you to them a gift, the gift of Salah, through which they will also experience their own ascension. I will accept them in my presence through this gift. When Messenger of Allah came back and started telling people all and everything about he has heard and seen, may all the non-believers rejected him. Some of the believers rejected him too. As soon as he found this out, a curse of the Jahil ran into the house of Hazrat Al-Jahil. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, the truthful one, the loyal one, and asked him, have you heard that your closest friend, Muhammad, was telling about that he was taken all the way to the heaven, and he has seen all these strange things? Have you heard of this ridiculous story? And Hazrat Abu Bakr turned to him and said, Abu Jahil, is this something that you made up, or is this something Muhammad is saying? And Abu Jahl says, an intelligent man like me, how could I make up something so ridiculous? Of course, this is your friend, who I mistakenly called Al-Amin, the trusted one, said all these things. And Hazrat Abu Bakr at that time is teaching us what it means to be loyal, what it means to be Siddiq, what it means to be truthful. He said that if these are the words of Rasulullah, I believe every word of it. I don't have any doubt in any of these. Then Abu Jahl, ran into the house of Rasulullah. He was very upset. And then he confronted Rasulullah. He asked him to lift one foot, which our master humbly did. And he asked him to lift the other foot. And he, while he was standing, with humility, our master said, Abu Jahl, I cannot. If I do, I fall. The enemy of Allah, as soon as he received this answer, you who cannot stand a finger's length above the ground, how could you claim that you went all the way up to the seven heavens? Here is the humility, here is the greatness of our Rasulullah, who said to him that, I did not say I went. I said I was brought. That level of humbleness, humility, and recognizing that he does not have anything, all the power, all the respect, all the honor of the light of ascension was given to him from Allah Ta'ala, made him the greatest prophet, made him the beloved of Allah Ta'ala, made him realize this beautiful ascension. Inshallah, when we are at the prostration, we also recognize our humility, our nothingness, through which we will be able to see and come closer to his divinity. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, all the most merciful, most compassionate one. You love to forgive our sins. For the honor of this blessed night, forgive our sins. We have committed in the past. Forgive our sins we are committing now. Forgive our sins we may commit in the future. Give us strength against the trials of this world. Give us patience through which we can see your divine presence in all and everything. You have blessed us with this beautiful religion, Islam. You have blessed us with Iman. Enable us to do good. Increase Ihsan. Ya Qadir, Ya Qawi, give us strength to cleanse our hearts from the evil qualities of arrogance, hypocrisy, vengeance, anger. Open our hearts to love and compassion. Ya Badir, Ya Wahid, unify your mate Muhammad. Open our hearts to love and compassion for each other. Close our eyes to the mistakes of each other. Ameen, ameen, alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdala al-Marwan. فتعاقب الاسران فكذب الجديدان واستقبل الفرقتان وبلغ روحاه الارواح اهل بيته من التحيه والسلام وبارك وسلم عليه كثيرا كثيرا كثيرا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى جميع الانبياء والمرسلين والاولياء والصالحين وعلى ملائكتك والمقربين وعلى اهل طاعتك اجمعين من اهل السماوات واهل الاراضين ورضوان الله تعالى على ال رسول الله واصحابه اجمعين امين امين والحمد لله رب العالمين.